Lord be with you. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Davidson United Methodist Church. On this very special day of worship, All Saints Sunday, we welcome everyone here and everyone worshiping with us online. A special, very special welcome to all those who are worshiping with us for the first time, and especially those who may be joining us because they are here to remember and honor someone that they love and who have lost, they've lost in this past year. As I'm speaking, I hope that everyone will have an opportunity to grab your fellowship pad that is at the end of your pew and to pick that up and sign it and register your attendance and pass it along to everyone who is in your row so that we can know who is joining us today. And we are so glad that you are with us today. This is a special day here at Davidson UMC, not only because of All Saints Sunday, but today is also our Missions Mall, an opportunity for you to help serve in the community. Our Missions Mall is located to my right over in the Alexander Education Building on the lower floor. If you have not started your Christmas shopping yet, boy, I sure have not, you can do that. You can pick up lots of arts and crafts over at the Missions Mall, and all of the purchases, all the proceeds from purchases or any gifts that you may want to offer there will go to help our mission partners, our internal and external mission partners, and I know they would appreciate your support. That is going on all morning up until 12:30 this afternoon. You can step over there right after the worship service this morning. I know they would appreciate your help and support. I want to remind you again, you've heard us say this the last couple of weeks, that our bishop, our newly reappointed Bishop Ken Carter, will be joining us next Sunday to be our guest preacher. He will be at all three of our services, 8 o'clock, 9:30, and 11. So we hope that you can come out and hear Bishop Carter preach and offer him a very warm Davidson UMC greeting when he joins us next Sunday morning. I noticed out in the gathering space that we do have some of our harvest procession bags that are still out there, and we hope that if you have not done so yet, you can pick up a harvest procession bag. Inside each one of those bags there is a little shopping list, and you can go to the grocery store and pick up all of the items on that list and come back in 2 weeks, November the 20th, and with those items, those full bags, and we will line up the chancel area with all those bags and ask God to bless them so that we can feed 250 families in our community and they can have a wonderful and blessed Thanksgiving, all because of your generosity. We are grateful for your generosity, for all the things that you do, all the time and all the gifts that you give to the church. You can give today by texting to the number that you see on your screen, the number that you see in the bulletin at the end of your order of service. You can always give by going to our website and placing your gifts in the offering cabinets when you are here on Sunday mornings. It is good to be together this morning in the house of the Lord. I invite you now to join with me as we pray the collect together. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have knit together your elect in one communion and fellowship in the mystical body of your Son, Christ our Lord. Give us grace so to follow your blessed saints in all virtuous and godly living, that we may come to those ineffable joys that you have prepared for those who truly love you. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, who with you in the Holy Spirit lives and reigns, one God, in glory everlasting. Amen. I invite you to stand.
Thank you.
I invite you now to join with me as we confess our sins before God and one another. Let us pray. Eternal God, in whom we live and move and have our being, whose face is hidden from us by our sins, in whose mercy we forget in the blindness of our hearts, cleanse us from all our offenses and deliver us from proud thoughts and vain desires. With that reverent and humble heart, we may draw near to you, confessing our faults, confiding in your grace, and finding in you our refuge and strength. Through Jesus Christ, your Son. Amen. Hear the good news. Christ died for us while we were yet sinners. That proves God's love toward us. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven.
Glory to God. Amen.
Reading for today is from Ephesians chapter 1, beginning with the 11th verse. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance towards redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. I have heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and your love towards all the saints. And for this reason, I do not cease to give thanks for you, as I remember you in my prayers. I pray that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give you a spirit of wisdom and revelation as you come to know him, so that with the eyes of your enlightened heart, you may know what is the hope to which he has called you, what are the riches of his glorious inheritance among the saints, and what is the immeasurable greatness of his power for us who believe, according to the working of his great power. God puts his power to work in Christ when he raised him from the dead and seated him as his right hand in the heavenly places, far above all rule and authority and power and dominion and above every name that is named, not only in this age, but also in the age to come. And he has put all things under his feet and made him head over all things for the church, which is his body, the fullness of him who fills all in all. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh!
Thank you.
Let us pray. Almighty God, on this All Saints Sunday, we give thanks to you for every Christian who has gone before us, who helped and encouraged us, who taught us the faith, who sacrificed themselves so that we might know the gospel for ourselves, and whose love gave us a glimpse of Jesus' love for us. Thank you for the saints in our lives. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Lord, just as your saints experience persecution and oppression in years past, many of your people still live with injustice today. So God, empower your people to be faithful followers and bold witnesses of Jesus' gospel today. As we remember your saints, embolden each of us to be one too. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those outside of your church, those who have left it, those who've been hurt by it. God, show us how we can help them see and experience the love of Jesus through our own words and deeds of love. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for those who are sick, who suffer from illness, and for their family members who are anxious for their health. For the poor, the hungry, the homeless, for those who are unemployed and depressed and lonely. God, help us love our neighbor as we love ourselves. Lord, in your mercy. We pray for our nation, for new leaders we will elect this week, for stability and unity and peace among your people. We pray for peace in our world, for the safety and protection of our military abroad, and for the care and comfort of their spouses and children at home. Lord, in your mercy. We give thanks for all the saints who have died in service of Jesus and now rest from their labor. Thank you for opening wide your arms of everlasting life, and we pray that you would comfort those who grieve for loved ones no longer with us on earth. We especially lift up this week the Smith family and the passing of Heather's father, the Alexander family, the death of Alice's husband, Davies, the Marion family and the passing of Lisa's mother. And as is our tradition, God, hear us lifting aloud our own concerns into this holy space now as we pray for living God, give us all the hope of eternal life that defeats death. Lord, in your mercy. God of life, thank you for the love you have shown the world through your saints. And now, renew our communion with all your saints, especially those whom we name before you now.
Mary Catherine Boyd. Helen Patricia Pat Callahan Delk. Evelyn Pauline Duty. Sarah Alexander Fox. Shirley Avis Freeman. Larry Roger Hagen. Anne Lorraine Hawk. Faye Blakely Hayes. Marlene Julia Catter. Donald Don Oscar K. Sr.
Pamela Bartlett Knight. Jesse Buddy Eugene Lippard. Catherine Kathy Louise McLeod. Ronald Ron Albert Muncy. Lois Evelyn Pippin. Rob William Richardson, Jr. Robert Bob Douglas Ruth. Kenneth Ken James Chiebner. Owen Ray O.R. Setzer. Gail Lynn Sievenen. Dorothy Walker Varner. Sarah Jane Wilson. God, since we are surrounded by so great a cloud of witnesses, strengthen us to run with perseverance the race set before us, looking to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, as we pray together the words he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Thank you. Deus omnem lacrimam ab oculis eorum. Et mors, mors, ulta,
special word of gratitude to Reverend Dr. Kevin Turner, to our choir and orchestra this morning for leading us in worship. I pray that this day has been a blessing to each of you, that we depart to go and be the saints in memory of the saints who have blessed our lives. And as we do, let's remember our mission together. We will be the body of Christ in our community through worship, education, fellowship, and service. Go in peace.